back with some Devin Townsend project.
Oh, you did?
So, this one that I'm about to do was suggested a while ago, and I know I've been bouncing around a lot. So, you know, just give me a second. Let me set this up. Alright, this is supposed to be the Death of Music Live. Now, again, I have not heard this. I have no idea what it sounds like. It sounds like it might be pretty heavy, and I don't know what the quality of the live show is going to be like. Because... oh, wait, never mind. It says it was taken from the DVD of his. So, let's see. I mean, this is kind of a gamble, but I put in the search engine, as you can see, DTP Death of Music, and this is one of the first things that came up, so I figured let's rock with that. I'm pausing it real quick just to say this sounds like this track would be a really good track to listen to in headphones. Shadows dance over the land.
Thank you.
kept expecting it to drop and get real heavy, man. That didn't happen. However, so this is not going to make sense. The drawback for me was that I kept thinking it was going to drop and get heavy, but at the same time, the fact that I thought that kind of kept me in the entire time. And now I say that this track would be good in a pair of headphones only because of the lower vocals. Now, I don't know if it's just my ears. I am partially deaf, but it seemed like even when he wasn't whispering into the mic that the sound was a little bit low. Now, I'm sure if you were there in the venue, it was good. And, you know, that's completely understandable. I get that. So, now, moving on, real quick, I just want to address, if you keep seeing me squinting and rubbing my eyes, it's because she was having a cigarette up here, and the fan only takes out so much. But now that we can move past that, I kept hearing him say that, you know, my friends are dead, or my friends were there, but basically they didn't do anything, and it was like the death of music. What that says to me, because this dude, obviously, he's into music, so he's a big music guy. I would imagine that he's saying that in the sense that your friends not being around is the same as if music were to die for you, because a small part of you would die inside because you feel like you're missing something. Now, I know I got a comment earlier today where somebody said that, you know, there are two types of people that listen to music. People that listen for the melody and the instruments, and the other person who listens to the lyrics first and then the other stuff. Now, obviously, as you can tell, I'm more of a lyrical kind of a guy.
A melody.
But, you know, if that's what he's saying, I mean, if I'm wrong, correct me in the comments, but if that's what he's saying, at least that makes sense to me, because you can hold those two things very close to you. And, you know, music and friendship are both equally important, but for completely different reasons. I don't know if I'm making much sense, but, like, in the sense that, look, when my favorite music died, it was rough. I had to go dig deep and find artists that were still doing things the quote-unquote right way. But, you know, that does, it takes a lot out of you, man. Or at least for me, it does. It kind of reminds me of the Sunset Limited, where, you know, in that movie, there's a conversation about how one of the characters in that movie says that, you know, all the books that he would read and the music that he would listen to just didn't hold the same value for him anymore. And that kind of drove him to the brink of suicide, because that was what gave his life meaning. So if that's what this song is about, I can 100% understand and relate to that. However, if I am wrong, which I will say there's probably a decent chance that I am, then by all means, you definitely correct me. Because, I mean, you guys, obviously, you know this music way better than I do. However, I would like to think that that's what it is. Either way, I have to give this guy credit for putting the show on that he does. Even with a track that is that calm, you can still see the showmanship in what he's doing. And that is really important. So, I mean, I would imagine, like I said, that that would be what it's about. If it's not, if that's not what it is, definitely explain it, because I'm really curious to know what else could it possibly be relevant to. And again, you know, you guys know this world way better than I do. And, you know, what I'm looking for right now is the round of applause, because I want to give this guy that, because he definitely deserves it. It seems like whether he's putting on a huge show like he did with Grace, and he has choirs up there and pyrotechnics and all that shit, he puts 100% into it, or if he's doing just more of a mellow song, he seems to be putting 100% into it also. Like, every song means just as much as the next, and that shit is really important. So, round of applause for him for that. No question. I know it took me a while to get back to this, but like I said, bouncing back and forth, so, you know, we'll get back into it. I'm just trying to go all over the place so we don't get stuck in a cycle of just doing the same thing with the same artist over and over again. Despite the fact of how good it might be or how well the numbers on the reactions are doing, because I want to give everybody's suggestion a chance.
An artist.
With that, yeah, an artist too, definitely. But with that being said, you know, I'm just gonna leave it here. You guys can let me know in the comments what you think, if this is one of the top tracks for you personally, and is this off of an album that you hold close to you out of his catalog? That would be another question that I would have, because I don't know 100%, but I would think that he has a very large body of work between Strapping Young Lads, Devin Townsend Project, that there's a lot going on there. So you guys let me know where this ranks for you out of all of those albums, because I really want to know. But I enjoyed that. I liked the showmanship. And I like the fact that he can become that, he, even when he's putting on a show that is not with all of the madness going on behind it, that it can still pull you in. I think that is the mark of a really, really good artist. So, with that being said, let me get the hell out of here, and I'll catch you guys on the next video.